Then let us start the first chapter, which is thermodynamic properties. In the first section, let me review the background of the thermodynamics. This slide summarizes the terms and symbols used in thermodynamics. V is a volume, which is space occupied by the system. P is pressure, which is mechanical energy per volume in the occupied space. W is work, which is mechanically transferred energy. Q is heat, which is energy transferred by thermal conduction. T is temperature, which is the driving force of thermal conduction. Heat is transferred from high temperature to low temperature part. E is internal energy. The matter can store energy within it, even though it is invisible. S is entropy, which is related to the number of draws to store energy by temperature. H is enthalpy, which is internal energy and mechanical energy stored in the matter. F is Helmholtz free energy, which represents the maximum work that the system can perform using internal energy E. G is Gibbs free energy, which is the maximum work that the system can perform using enthalpy. Let me introduce the basic laws of thermodynamics. The first one is, of course, the first law of the thermodynamics, which is the differential of internal energy is equal to differential of heat minus differential of work. In the thermodynamics, the work is almost always done by volume change at pressures. Therefore, dW is equal to pdV. Therefore, dE is equal to dQ minus pdV. This means the internal energy increase is equal to heat into the system minus the work done by the system. This expresses the conservation of energy. This also means matter can store energy even though it is invisible. If volume remains unchanged, the increased energy, internal energy E, is equal to heat into the system. Therefore, D is dQ, equation 1.1.2. The equation 1.1.1 can be written in this way: dQ is equal to dE plus pdV. This equation means the heat into the system is used for the internal energy increase and also for the volume increase. Equation 1.1.1 prime. The next is the second law of thermodynamics. The second law of thermodynamics is mathematically expressed by this equation. The differential of entropy S, dS, is greater than or equal to the differential of heat, dQ, divided by temperature, T, equation 1.1.3. In the case of equality, the process is reversible. In the case of inequality, the process is irreversible. Namely, if the process is reversible, the entropy increases by the ratio of heat into the system to temperature T. Many processes in the Earth and planetary interiors are reversible. The typical exception is thermal conduction. In any way, in the most cases, the process is reversible. Therefore, the equality is held. The differential of entropy, dS, is equal to the differential of heat, dQ over T. This equation can be written as dQ is equal to T dS, equation 1.1.4. By combining the first law and the second laws of thermodynamics in the reversible case, we have dE is equal to dQ minus pdV is equal to TdS minus pdV, because dQ is equal to TdS in the reversible case. Equation 1.1.5. This equation can be written TdS is equal to dE plus pdV. This equation means both energy increase and also volume increases the system entropy S. At the constant volume, of course, the pdV is zero, therefore dE is equal to TdS, equation 1.1.6. Then let me introduce several thermodynamic functions. First is enthalpy H. Enthalpy H is significant because heat added into the system can be stored not only as internal energy, but also stored as volume increase at pressure pdV. The definition of enthalpy H is equal to internal energy E plus the product of pressure and volume. The total differential of enthalpy H is equal to dE, the internal energy increase, plus VdP plus pdV. Because the dE is equal to TdS minus pdV, therefore dH, the total differential of enthalpy H, is equal to TdS plus VdP. This means the increase of enthalpy can be made by entropy increase at temperature or pressure increase with volume. At constant pressure, namely dP equals zero, the increase of enthalpy dH is equal to T times dS, entropy increase at temperature, equation 1.1.9. The next thermodynamic function is Helmholtz free energy F. Helmholtz free energy F is important because some part of internal energy E is available for work, but some part is not. Namely, energy, internal energy contains energy stored as entropy TdS, which is bound to the system and therefore unavailable for work. Therefore, free energy F is a part of internal energy available for work. The definition of Helmholtz free energy F is equal, F is defined as the internal energy minus the product of temperature and entropy S. Equation 1.1.10. The total differential of Helmholtz free energy F dF is equal to dE minus SdT minus TdS. Because the dE, the differential of internal energy E, is equal to TdS minus PdV. Therefore, TdS term cancels with minus TdS term. Therefore, the differential of Helmholtz free energy is equal to minus SdT minus PdV. Therefore, if temperature increase or volume increase, then Helmholtz free energy decreases. Equation 1.1.1. Next is Gibbs free energy, G. Some part of enthalpy H is available for work, but some part is not. Because enthalpy H is stored as TdS, which is bound to the system and therefore unavailable. G is a part of enthalpy which is available for work. Therefore, definition of Helmholtz free Gibbs free energy G is enthalpy H minus the product of temperature and entropy, which is equal to internal energy minus the temperature T times entropy S plus the pressure P times the volume V. Equation 1.1.2. The total differential of Gibbs free energy G, dG, is equal to the differential of internal energy dE minus TdS minus SdT plus PdV plus VdP. Because again, that dE is equal to TdS minus PdV, this dE is replaced by TdS minus PdV, and TdS from the differential of internal energy cancels with TdS minus TdS, and PdV cancels minus PdV from the internal energy dE is cancelled with PdV. Therefore, the differential of Gibbs free energy is equal to minus SdT plus VdP. Equation 1.1.3. Then, let me introduce Maxwell's relations. Let us consider the function z, which is the function f of x and y. Then, the total differential of z is equal to some function of z, which is a function of x and y, times the differential of x, plus some function h, which is a function of x and y times dy. Then, of course, this function g x y is equal to the partial differential of z with respect to x at constant y, and this h is equal to the partial differential of z with respect to y at constant x, equation 1.1.14. If the function z equals fxy is continuous and differentiable, then we can change the order of partial differential. Namely, the partial differential of z with respect to x, its partial differential with respect to y is equal to the partial differential with respect to x of partial differential of z with respect to y. Namely, because that dz, partial differential of z with respect to x is equal to function g, and partial differential of z with respect to y is equal to h, the partial differential of g with respect to y at constant x is equal to partial differential of h with respect to x at constant y. Equation 1.1.15. We apply the equation 1.1.15 into the combination of the first and the second laws of thermodynamics. dE is equal to TdS minus PdV. Then the function z is equal to the internal energy E, and x is entropy S, and y is volume V, and g is temperature T, and h is minus P. Therefore, g, which is T, is equal to the partial differential of the internal energy E with respect to entropy S at constant volume. This one. And minus P, function H, is equal to the partial differential of internal energy E with respect to volume V at constant entropy. Therefore, with from the equation 1.1.15, the partial differential of T with respect to volume at constant entropy is equal to partial differential over minus P with respect to entropy S at constant volume V. So this is the first Maxwell relations. We apply the same logic to more thermodynamic functions. For the second one is enthalpy H. dH is equal to TdS plus PdV. Then the function z is equal to the enthalpy H. X is entropy S. Y is pressure P. And g is temperature T, and h is volume V. Then T is equal to the partial differential of enthalpy H with respect to entropy S at constant temperature P, equation 1.1.19. And V is equal to the partial differential of enthalpy H with respect to pressure P at constant entropy S, equation 1.1.20. Then we have the second Maxwell's relation, the partial differential of temperature with respect to pressure P at constant entropy S is equal to the partial differential of a volume V with respect to entropy S at constant pressure P, equation 1.1.12. We apply the same logic to Helmholtz free energy F. dF is equal minus S dT minus P dV. Then the Z is Helmholtz free energy F, X is the temperature T, Y is the volume V, G is minus S entropy, and H is minus P pressure. Then minus S is equal to the partial differential of Helmholtz free energy F with respect to the temperature T at constant volume V. The minus P is equal to the partial differential of Helmholtz free energy F with respect to volume V at constant temperature T, equation 1.1.23. Then we have the third Maxwell's relation. The partial differential of entropy S with respect to volume V at constant temperature T is equal to the partial differential of the pressure P with respect to the temperature T at constant volume V, equation 1.1.24. Then last, we apply it for Gibbs free energy G. dG is equal to minus S dT plus V dP. So small z is equal to large G, Gibbs free energy G. X is equal to T, the temperature, and Y is equal to the pressure P. The function small g is equal to minus entropy S, and H is equal to the volume V. Then minus entropy S is equal to the partial differentiation of the Gibbs free energy G with respect to temperature T at constant pressure, equation 1.1.25, and V, the volume V is equal to the partial differential of the Gibbs free energy G with respect to the pressure P at constant temperature T, equation 1.1.26, and then we have the fourth Maxwell's relation minus the partial differential of the entropy S with respect to the pressure P at constant temperature T is equal to the partial differential of the volume V at with respect to temperature T at constant pressure P, equation 1.1.27. Please let me explain why Maxwell's relations are useful. The pressure, temperature, and volume and entropy are main thermodynamic variables to describe the system. Although we can measure the pressure, temperature, and volume relatively easily, the entropy is difficult to obtain. If we use the Maxwell's relations, the relations with the entropy can be converted to relations with other variables. One of the clear examples is this relation. We can convert the partial derivative of pressure with respect to temperature at constant volume to that pressure derivative of entropy with respect to volume at constant temperature. Also, this equation, the partial differential of volume with respect to temperature at constant pressure can be converted to minus of the partial derivative of entropy with respect to pressure at constant temperature. In this slide, let me define frequently used properties. The first one is thermal expansivity, namely thermal expansion coefficient alpha. The definition of thermal expansivity is 1 over the volume V times the partial derivative of a volume with respect to temperature at constant pressure. The next is the isothermal bulk modulus KT. The definition of KT is minus V times the partial derivative of pressure with respect to volume at constant temperature. The third one is the adiabatic bulk modulus KS. The definition of KS is minus V times the partial derivative of pressure with respect to volume at constant entropy. These three definitions can be written in this way. In these ways, these relations indicate the thermal expansivity is an increasing rate of the relative volume to the increasing temperature. The isothermal bulk modulus can be written in this way. Thus, it is the rate of pressure increase by the decrease in volume V. The adiabatic bulk modulus is as well. The difference is at constant temperature or constant entropy. At the end of this chapter, please let me explain the chain rule. The chain rule is not thermodynamics, but the mathematical relation. The chain rule is a relation among three parameters of a function over three parameters. So let such function be f and three variables be x, y, z, and function is equal to constant c. Then the chain rule is the partial derivative of y with respect to x at constant z is equal to minus the partial derivative of z with respect to x at constant y over the partial derivative of z with respect to y at constant x. Please see this diagram, this illustration. So this is x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. And the function f is expressed on this surface. This red dot line shows the partial derivative over y with respect to x at constant z. This green line shows the partial derivative over z with respect to y at constant x. And this blue line shows the partial derivative of z with respect to x at constant y. So let us consider the partial derivative of y with respect to x at constant z is ratio of this delta y, which is a length from this corner to here, to minus delta x length from here to here. Minus sign is because it is not from here to here, but from here to here. Then similarly, the delta z, the partial derivative of z with respect to y at constant x is ratio of z with respect to minus delta x. And the partial derivative of z with respect to x at constant y is equal to the ratio of delta z to minus delta x. Therefore, minus the partial derivative of z with respect to x at constant y over the partial derivative of z over with respect to x at constant x is equal to the ratio minus the ratio of delta z over minus delta x divided by the ratio of delta z over minus delta y. Therefore, the z, delta z are cancelled, and the x in the denominators in the both denominator both side is moved to the other side, and which is minus delta y over delta x, and which is equal to the partial derivative of y with respect to x at constant z. So this is the end of the chapter 1, thermodynamic properties, section 1, background of the thermodynamics. Thank you very much.